why the wrong way. Here you see me assembling the jig, and so far so good. So this this was correct. I made it and it worked well. But then I made the error to cut the pieces, cut the struts to length, and I shouldn't have done that. I will explain in the end of the video why not, why it is better to first assemble and then cut to length.
So this is my hexagon shape. The outer dimensions are the net dimensions from the 3D model, and then I now put up these guides for making the final triangles. So if I put the cut beams onto this, it should come exactly. It should be the net dimensions. So now I need to cut the angles for the beams to make sure that everything's working fine. Yeah, so that's it. Then I need to make 54 of those triangles for the hexagons. I will make some extra for windows, and then I will make the second shape for the pentagons. I think I will put up my angles on the saw and cut them all in advance. Make sure I have the exact lengths, so I can assemble afterwards in one series.
One-handed, it's not that simple. Here I'm drilling holes for the corner vise. Make it a little easier for assembling the triangles. I made a little stand to get the right angle, and now it's a matter of a couple of seconds per beam. So all the wood for the hexagons has been cut. So a hexagon is 6 times the strangle. I have 2 equal struts and then 1 shorter strut. As all the struts have a beveled angle, I needed to cut one side with the angle of the corner, but also with the bevel to match the other strut. How would I show you? So if I have one here and then another one there, actually this one matches the bevel that is here on the other strut, so I needed to cut the angle right, this one, and I needed to cut in a beveled way to match this side, this beveled side. So it's quite a lot of sewing work. I have 54 triangles for the hexagons and some extras for the windows. So I have left side of the triangle, I have right side of the triangle, and then I have the bottom of the triangle, so the shorter struts. And what I'm doing now is I am drilling holes in the struts to make it easier for mounting. So I will get one long vise here too to mount my to make my triangles. I have 60 pieces of each length, 60 struts of each length. So that makes 54 triangles and 6 windows. Normally, tomorrow I should be able to start creating the triangles, and then after that create a half hexagons, because they need to be covered in that shape. Half a hexagon is the biggest shape I can cover without having wrinkles or overlapping foil because of the angles. Okay, but that's for maybe for later this week.
So now for the assembly of the triangles, I put my 3 different struts on the jig. The fact that I drilled the hole means now that I don't have to clamp my pieces, except keeping them tight together. There's still some quirks, in a sense that sometimes a strut is a little too long, so I then use some sanding with the machine to sand it flush with the other strut. But overall, this is going more or less as planned. The struts not all being perfect in length was the problem I encountered afterwards. When mounting the half hexagons, I saw that you need to be precise on the millimeter.
So here I had, sometimes I had some play, sometimes I had no play. So this meant that all my triangles were slightly different, and that's not a good idea. So I had to dismount them all afterwards and rework them in another way. But you'll see that in another video.
So I have two struts of equal length for the hexagon. Well, for the hexagon triangles. And then the base is a little shorter. I use 60 millimeter screws. A little grease to make them go in easier. So I am now making the half hexagons from the triangles I prepared before, and I have discovered that my triangles were not quite precise enough. So sometimes I have a little gap here. And this is not okay, because when you assemble the hexagons, you need to have very precise measurements to have the exact size around. So I am now disassembling these. Making sure that this one gets firmly pressed against my jig, so I get a little overshoot here. So I cannot cut them to length before assembling. So I must cut one size, the angle, straight out of the corner angle here, straight, and then I must keep a little overshoot here, assemble the other one against it, firmly pressed against the jig, and then cut flush with this side. That's a better way to do it than to pre-cut all these to length, because even if you have only 1 millimeter excess wood, that makes your final triangle not the exact size. So this makes for a lot of extra work now, but for the pentagons, I will proceed differently, which will be a lot quicker.